I'd like to ask you guys a quick favor. There's a possibility that the comments today the video might be a little bit controversial. I don't know. I'm thinking that it might be. Just for whatever reason, just from what I've seen on social media. But if you guys could do me a favor and help me, like, just help keep the comments from getting too crazy, all you guys that I know watch every day, if you could keep an eye on the comment section, I'd appreciate it. Good morning, friends and family. How are we doing on this beautiful day? Let's not forget that today is a beautiful day to be alive, just like every other day is a beautiful day to be alive. Even if you got holes in your pants, it doesn't matter. You're still here, you're alive, you're with us, you have a chance to experience. And that is priceless. I'm gonna be sitting here at my desk for most of the day getting a bunch of work done. And to those of you that got fooled on last Friday's video, I'm sorry. I only fooled you for about 4.5 minutes into the 18-minute video, so if you didn't watch the whole thing, that's your own fault, really. And there were plenty of you that got caught off guard for a second, running around your house screaming, just going off, and then you realized, wait a minute, hold on a second. And then some of you actually fooled me, because some of you are like, oh, I'm gonna turn this fan off. I think some of you actually fooled me because you're saying congratulations on the baby, new Cusco, and it's like, yeah, those are legitimate responses, even if it's what I was trying to fool. Hey, you guys, I think some of you guys are fooling me now. Dang it. That's what I get, right? So I'm starting off my morning with a beautiful cup of this stuff. Something Hillary refers to as golden milk. I'm pretty sure there's turmeric in here. Anyways, fantastic. It's got a nice little kick to it. Have you guys ever heard of golden milk? Pretty decent. So anyway, for today's video, I had a really stupid idea. Call it what it is, maybe stupid, and sure, go ahead and slap that dislike button while you're at it. Stupid ideas. Because I know my mom does not like the word stupid. She's gonna be watching this video thinking, stop saying stupid, I don't like it. For what it's worth, sorry, Mom. Or slap the like button for stupid ideas, because sometimes they can be entertaining. My stupid idea is I'm gonna see if any of my snakes will bite me in the face. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, Brian, don't be an idiot. It's not possible. There's not a day that goes by when I don't have at least one idiotic moment in each day. I can promise you that. Today's just gonna be on camera. I've got a bet going with myself and maybe some of you guys that I am not gonna get bit. So there. But there's only one way to find out. But before we run too far into this video, I want to make sure to give out a shout out to some of our very supportive Patreon family. Liam Armenta, Louis Sai, Greg Touche, Lori Johnson, Garrett Hartle. Oh man, I forgot a couple. I was gonna memorize them all. Son of a biscuit. No, don't cut away from the clip. Just remember, Garrett Hartle, Ed Velardo, and Shannon Smith. Memory. Gotta work on that memory, guys. Can't let everything just be saved in your phone. And I want to give a very special shout out to my very good friend, Carla, over at One Soft Kiss. Link in the description for her channel. Carla has been working with snakes, I think, since I was in diapers and maybe even before. Not just like she got a snake when she was a baby. Like she knew what she was doing well before I even knew what a snake was. I highly recommend going out and checking out her channel. All right, guys, let's do this.
Tiny Daddy. Yes. That's pickle. That's Daddy. Hey, Tiny Kicker. Yes. Where is Tiny Kicker? No, I don't know where the Tiny Kicker is. Whatsoever I feel has come to light. And whatsoever I fall, we came out.
Check out Daddy's socks. So we've got our safety technician, Mr. Eli Scrimmins, on the scene today. Just making sure nothing crazy happens, making sure that we're safe. Right, Eli? You got us covered?
Yeah.
Yeah, and he's also gonna be doing a little filming of his own to capture it in as many angles as we can. Oh, I just want to say a little something about our... What is going on in there? Whoa, that's cool. I wanted to say something about our Music Monday artist, Mr. Chris Cornell, Soundgarden. Awesome guy, awesome artist. We saw him a couple times. Hillary and I, on one of our very first dates, actually went to Orange County Fair and saw him, and I was just blown away. I grew up listening to Soundgarden, but seeing him live was just mind-blowing. Then we got to see him a second time live in Belgium at Werchter, and he was playing with Metallica, and that was equally incredible. And he just blew me away with his how his voice just live was amazing. What is going on down there? You have a camera.
I don't want to go this way.
Well, then don't. This guy's got his own camera. He's getting camera envy. He's got his own camera down there. Anyway, yeah, Chris Cornell, Soundgarden. Hope you guys like it. Just so we got one thing square, I am a professionally trained YouTuber. Don't be doing stupid stuff like this at your own house, okay? Unless you know what you're doing. So this reminds me of my childhood, okay? There was a time when I was 7 years old and I had my first snake. It was my first snake I was holding. I had her for a few years at this point, or him. And I was just kind of checking him out and putting him close to my nose, and little rosy rat snake, and just grabbed my nose and let go. And I was like, oh, and even then at 7 years old, I was like, well, that was my fault. You found the snakeys?
Yeah.
Good job, bud. So my idea is that I'm not going to get bit. The point of this video I'm hoping to get across is that snakes are not dumb animals, and they know the difference between my nose and a rat. Just because it's putting off a warm heat signature, they've got a great sense of smell, they're not just going to go biting my nose, because I'm just going to show how docile all snakes can be. Now, there are a couple snakes here that I'm a little bit worried about, and it's not the big ones. There's a couple little ones I think might get me, but we'll see what happens. We'll go on down the line. And so the idea is I'm gonna take the snake directly from their enclosure and just kind of put their nose to my nose. And they either bite or they don't. I'm willing to bet that the majority of these things go like that. Well, there are a couple I'm worried about though. Let's just keep it moving.
Don't try. It's daddy. Don't.
Yeah, could have expected that. Okay, you can hold that after I do the test, okay? Make sure the snake's not gonna bite you. Oedipus, coral globe. Now Eli's gonna take over. Here you go, bud. This girl's in shed, so she can't see very well right now. So if any of the ball python babies are gonna get me, it's gonna be this girl right here. How you doing, baby girl? Yep, nope. See, and maybe Eli will try this too. That'd be pretty funny. Although Eli's been bit several times and he's still not deterred. I got bit in the face when I was 7 years old. I obviously didn't get deterred. Alright, we're up in the ante a little bit here. Big blood python. But, you know, I don't see it. I don't think she's gonna do it. I know this girl, and I just don't see it happening. If anything, she wants nothing to do with my face, really. I don't blame her. It's like, look at this idiot. Reticulated python. This is Buttercup, and she's a sweetheart. There's no way in hell she's gonna bite me in the nose. Again, she just doesn't even, like, they don't even want anything to do with my face. I can't even get her to touch my nose. Oh man, I love these snakes. Alright, now if there's any snake that I was really worried about this happening with, it's gonna be this guy. This guy's bit me more than any other snake here, really. Because I didn't raise him, for one. And he's a little skittish, and this is Elvis. But now that he's out, I think a majority of these snakes, if I just stuck my face in, would probably have a go at it. But once they're out and being held, just not happening. Even with this guy. Squares me up, takes a good look, and okay, the next two snakes too stand a pretty good chance for giving me a good little whack. We'll see. Scrub python, experiment. This is the female. She's actually less flighty than the male. So, and I've been able to actually just give her little pets under the chin. That being said, harder to get a snake to touch your nose than I thought. This is Frank. He's the male scrub python, and good God, he is just, he's a gorgeous animal, man. Look at this guy. He is just a beautiful, beautiful snake. Oh my gosh. Let's take a look at that. Man, that's a gorgeous animal right there. Anyway, I don't think he's gonna bite me in the face either, even though he's the more skittish of the two. Oh, or not. He's gotta give me that look. Does it count if I didn't touch noses? It doesn't count, right? Oh, man. Okay, no bite. He sure looks like something. I love how these guys just S up like that. Look at how cool that is. You in here again?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I know you guys heard that noise. And this girl is second in line for having bit me more than any other snakes here. But... look at that nose-to-nose touch. Yeah! We're good, man. See, snakes aren't stupid. Snakes are not stupid. I might be stupid. And if you think so after watching this video, you're probably right. After all that, we don't even need to get Halo out of that. We know she's not gonna bite my face. And another thing we're not gonna do is we're not gonna get out the Pied. That snake will bite my face and it will not be good. So that is not happening. But we know that about that snake. I didn't honestly know most of these snakes, so I've never gone nose to nose with any of the other snakes. The Pied would be a different story. We're not going there. All right, one last variable we didn't try was the carpet python. She's... I told you guys, man, I knew I wasn't gonna get bit by any snakes, man. I just knew it. This snake has actually bit Eli before, and Eli doesn't care, right? Yeah. Not a big deal to take a bite from a little snakey like this, right?
Yes.
Yep.
I want to guard it, Daddy.
Okay. All right, corn snake. Probably the least likely snake to bite ever.
Corn snake.
Hold your horses, Biscuit. Yep. Nope. There you go. It's too crazy for you?
Yeah. Why do you know, Daddy?
What do I know?
Yeah.
I know that Eli is one of the cutest little boys I ever saw in my life.
Yeah!
You agree with that?
What does Mommy like?
What does Mommy like?
Yeah.
Mommy likes Daddy.
Oh, okay. What Eli likes?
Eli likes scorpions.
Yeah! What Halo likes?
Halo likes rabbits.
What Buttercup likes?
Buttercup? She likes rats.
She likes rats. Who that likes?
She likes Eli.
Oh, you like drinking water?
Yeah, I like drinking water.
And Mommy likes drinking water too.
Yeah.
I need some your water, Daddy.
Okay, turn off the camera.
Just as long as
people, Triple B TV is live. Well, it's not live yet. If you're watching this vlog right when it came out, then it's still got 3 hours to go. But if you're watching this vlog and it's already been out for 3 hours, then Triple B is live. Triple B TV. Link right here. If you guys aren't watching the Triple B TV episodes, man, I don't know what you're doing. You're missing out. It is awesome. We're looking at like some super teeny tiny reticulated pythons, like small. You should really give it a look. It's really pretty cool. I mean, look at these lights. Look at this setup. I don't want to just be making these things with putting all this effort into it. If you're not gonna go watch it, why don't we go upstairs and see what? I think Noah, Sage, and Mommy are home. Yeah, let's go see what's up with those guys. It has been pouring rain all day. And so, but Eli and I did go for a little bit of herp mission, so that was kind of cool. But it's, look at this. I know I've caught way more epic raindrops than that, but you know, I got a lot of work today. I can't spend 100 million minutes, that sounds ridiculous. I can't spend 100 million minutes just filming raindrops today. Too much other stuff to do. Look at. I came in here thinking that the raindrops would look more impressive on the glass of the windshield, but it's not actually coming down very heavy right now. It was coming down pretty heavy earlier, but no, not right now. All right, let's get it. Let's go inside. Yes, the infamous Tinley boots. If you missed that episode with Dave Kaufman about those boots, then, well, go check it out. How does it feel to have a camera in your face right after you wake up while you're pregnant and almost ready to go? Good times? So I wonder if I could ask you something. I put up this video today, or I haven't put it up yet. It's this vlog right here that's going up, this video right here that everybody's watching. I did a thing with the snakes where I went around to see if any of the snakes would bite me on the nose. Mm-hmm. What do you think about that?
Apparently it didn't happen, right?
Well, no, I didn't get bit on the nose, no. Mm-hmm. But what do you think? Do you have any thoughts? Like, do you think that's an idiotic thing to do, or?
If you're trying to show people that they're, you know, not aggressive and don't want to bite you.
That was my main point, yes, to show that they're not just mindless eating, biting machines, that they, well, that I could tuck into my nose and that they wouldn't bite me.
Yeah. I mean, especially if you did it with the smaller ones.
I had the Burmese python, too.
Yeah, maybe that one wasn't so smart.
Yeah, well, I just wanted your opinion because it's like one of those things. I put it up. Hey, screamings. It's you know, while I'm filming, I'm thinking, you know, inevitably going to be people that are just like, "What are you doing? You're an idiot for doing that." And I'm just like, I just see it happening already. But I did it. And it's happening.
Well, yeah, I wouldn't make a habit out of it, but well, I think that it's good for some people, you know, to see that. And if you stick your face at them, that they don't really want to bite you.
Yeah, but they might.
They might.
So safety first. I probably should have been wearing safety glasses, but I wasn't.
And
don't,
I mean,
just because you see something on the internet doesn't mean you're supposed to go and do it yourself, right? That's how you learn. You watch other stupid people on the internet, so you don't have to do the stupid stuff yourself.
Well, maybe you should just make the video called "I Did a Stupid Thing."
What did you? No.
I know. My birthday.
What about your birthday?
Dad, it's in 4 days, and when it's tomorrow, there will only be 3 days, and when it's the day after tomorrow, then it will be only 2 days. And then when it will be the day after, after 2 days, then there will be 1 day, and that will be my birthday.
Well, what day is that?
What day is my birthday?
I'm not trying to remember.
Saturday.
No.
Wednesday.
March.
March 20th.
Yes. Which is a Tuesday.
Baby sister and you might have the same birthday. doing, Donkey Dippy? Ah!
What you gonna do in there now, huh?
Oh no!
Double action! It's a rhino! Eli's a rhinoceros!
Muskox!
A couple of rhinos, a couple of ram heads.
Yeah. Oh, you just gave me punchy rhino. Hey, easy on the crazy violence.
Whoa, what do you think you're doing with that foot up there?
No! No!
What are you guys doing to me? What? What are you guys? What is happening right now? My eyeballs. You guys are going down and shit.
That's it. You guys have had it. You monsters.
How'd that feel?
It felt kind of good.
Couple of dinky donkeys. What are you doing with that iPad? Put that iPad away. We're wrestling.
Like that one? This is Noah Sage's very first sleepover away from mommy and daddy overnight. Is that right? Right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's gonna be your first time sleeping away without mommy or daddy. It's too much rain out there for the camera. But we can go bug hunting.
Okay.
You wanna go bug hunting?
Yeah.
No cameras allowed, sorry. So we came to the decision that we need to give our little local herp area here a little bit of a break because we've been breaking into their spot a little bit too much. Since we couldn't find any scorpions or black widows or anything like that outside, Eli had me draw some. I'm not a drawing artist, okay? Scorpion, black widow, and for fun we threw in a great white shark. Oh yeah. What do you guys think about that? Around scrimloppies or crippleloppa crayloofs and you read la d-doors. Sorry, these are the names that the boys and I call each other. I hope you guys enjoyed yourselves today. If you didn't, man, I don't know what to tell you. We try to make these days enjoyable around here, but if you didn't enjoy it, then, well, I guess we failed. But if we didn't fail, then make sure to leave us a little like, you know, touch it, feel it, play with it a little bit, see how you feel about it, and you know, whatever you do, make sure you hit it twice. No, don't hit it twice. Hit it once or three times, but not twice. Don't hit it twice. Twice isn't good. No even numbers, all odd numbers. And Eli, help me out. I'm trying to sign off, and I don't know what to say anymore. I don't know. Can you come help me out? Thanks.
What?
Come on up here. I just need a little help. Climb up. Oh, climb up. Oh, come on. You can do it. Get up. Oh, yo. Come on, Nakey boy. So, we're saying goodbye. And, come on. We're saying goodbye. And can you say goodbye with me?
Bye.